Standard 9th, Subject English, Chapter, Please Listen. Welcome children, today's topic is Please Listen. It is a poem. So let's start. When I ask you to listen to me and you start giving me advice, you have not done what I asked. When I ask you to listen to me and you begin to tell me why I shouldn't feel that way, you are trampling on my feelings. When I ask you to listen to me and you feel you have to do something to solve my problem, you have failed me, strange as that may seem. The poet is describing situation which occurs in everyone's life sometimes. A person wants to talk to his friend or relative and give vent to his emotions or frustrations. If the other person listens to him patiently, the former feels relieved. But this is not the case every time. Instead of listening and comforting the worried person, people try to belittle his worries by giving advice or ignore his feelings. Now let us proceed further with the poem. Listen. All I ask is that you listen. Don't talk or do, just hear me. Advice is cheap, 20 cents will get. You both, dear Abby and Billy Graham. In the same newspaper. Here the poet says you should listen without talking. He says that advice is very cheap in 20 cents. You can get advice from renowned columnist. And I can do for myself. I am not helpless. Maybe discouraged and faltering, but not helpless. Here the poet says that he can take action for himself as he is not helpless. He may be discouraged and faltering, but he is not helpless and will find his own solutions in due course of time. When you do something for me that I can and need to do for myself, you contribute to my fear and inadequacy. Here he says, when you do something that even I can do, you contribute to my fear and inadequacy. If a person is treated as a poor thing who cannot look after himself, then he will lose his confidence altogether. But when you accept as a simple fact that I feel what I feel, no matter how irrational, then I can stop trying to convince you and get about this business of understanding what's behind this irrational feeling. Here the poet says that when you accept that I feel what I feel, I can stop trying to convince you. He will have some time to figure out why he is feeling so. But to do that, first you should stop arguing with him and leave him alone. And when that's clear, the answers are obvious and I don't need advice. Irrational feelings make sense when we understand what's behind them. In the following stanza, the poet says, when reasons behind his feelings are clear, there is no need of any advice. Perhaps that's why prayer works sometimes. For some people, because God is mute and he doesn't give advice or try to fix things, God just listens and lets you work it out for yourself. In this stanza, the poet gives a twist to his narration. He says that now I understand why prayers work out as solutions for some people. He says that God is a good listener. He does not start talking or to fix things for the person who is aggrieved. He is mute. So the person starts thinking for himself and solves his problems on his own. What he really needed was an ear to speak out his woes. So please listen and just hear me. And if you want to talk, wait a minute for your turn and I will listen to you. And in the ending lines, he advises to listen him and says, if you want to talk, wait for your turn. So children, hope you understood the poem.